Hey guys, so today I'll be teaching you how to make a paper boomerang. This is a bit intermediate and you'll be needing to make neat creases. So all you need for this is one A4 paper, and not even one A4 paper, you just need half of it. So you take one edge and fold it to the other edge, just like that. And then crease. And then you can take a scissor and cut it. Once you cut the papers, you'll get something like this. So you just need one paper. So you can keep this aside and you will get one boomerang out of one half. So let's get started. We hold the paper just like this and then fold it in half. Bring one edge to the other edge. The folds need to be precise. So after you have folded it in half, crease well. Now you can unfold it and then take these flaps and fold them to the center. But leave a very tiny gap, say about half a millimeter or less than that. So crease well. I've left a bit of space. And do it to the other side, so you can flip it over and do it. We are leaving a bit of space so that when we fold it in half, the papers don't collide. Your folding should look something like this. So now, when you fold it in half, you see it's okay. So now, you can just unfold it and then rotate it and fold it in half. If the paper is stiff, you can just put your finger here and just tug. You might want to hold it here and then crease. Crease well. After this, what you must do is make something like a water bomb base. So you fold the flaps in. You might want to hold it here because it goes out of alignment. So just fold the flaps into the middle. Just like that. And crease well. And then do it to the other side. If you crease well, it will be good because the next part requires your creasing to be good. So now, if you want to make your creases stronger, you can flip it over and do the same thing. You're just making the creases stronger, even though you're doing the same thing. Okay, once you have done that, you can just do the water bomb base into these flaps. So you just bring it like this and then push the flaps in and fold the paper back. Again, just bring the paper like this, push it and bring it back. And flatten out the paper. And just crease well. After this, you have to open your model, and if you're a left-hander, you can open this side, but if you're a right-hander, you can open this side. So you just need to open this side, and we need, you see this diamond here, let me just mark it with a pencil for you. This diamond is the creases, so we need to make each of these creases better. So we fold it on that line, and then we flip it over like this. So now we can just take this side and crease it, and then do the same with the other. You just might want to pinch it. So while you're doing this, you can see it's popping out, that which is what you want. Okay, so once you have done it, it looks something like this. So you want to pinch here and then just push it, which, if you notice, squashes the pyramid. That is what you want. So just bring it to the edge here and just crease. So if you make the creases correct, it will be good. So now what you want to do is bring this squashed pyramid and fold it downwards. Let me have a close-up there. Now the pyramid looks like this. So just crease it well. This was the hard part. You might want to set it on a hard surface to do it. So just fold it like this. And now you can just push over here, and then what you see is that it just squashes like this, and it has something here. So now what you want to do is bring this down and bring this down, which has a triangle here which you want to fold to the left. So you might see that there is a flap here and it's like a pocket. So what you want to do is you have to tuck this into here. So you have to open it like this, and you see there's a pocket here. So just put it in, and then just put this part, this triangle part, like I showed you, this triangle part, just crease it well. Just put it in. Let me show you. So put it in, fold it well, just like that. And then bring it like this and just crease. Then just bring the other paper like that and just crease well. Now your boomerang looks good, but you need to keep this, you need to lock the boomerang. So your boomerang must look something like that, this. Yeah, but anyway, let's just close this. So now what you see, just go to the end of any, go to the end of the boomerang, and then you see there are two flaps. Just fold it in half, just like that. Crease, do it with the other side, just like that. And open one flap that is to the right, close it, and then open this. And what you, this, you have to open it and just tuck this in, just push it in. So then you get a triangle and just push it in. So now you can close it, and you have, if you notice, you have a pocket here. So you want to put this triangle inside this pocket, just like that. So now we have made it pointy and you have locked it, so it won't come out. Just crease it. Make everything as flat as possible. Don't bend it. Okay, so now do it the same with this side. So you fold the right and do the same here. So just fold the other flap in and then put the right in. So you open this and tuck it in. And like before, you open this and close it. And there's a pocket here and you have to put it in. Now make everything as flat as possible. As flat as possible. So it should look like this. You can use colored paper as you wish. It just needs to be A4. So now if it looks something like this, you're good. It should be as flat as possible. So now let me show you how to throw it. So what you want to do is hold it like this and flick your wrist. So don't hold it like this with this. You need to have it with this part here. This part which has a pocket here. But this part doesn't. So it's this part and you hold it like this and just flick your wrist. And if you throw it correct and you have made the folds correctly, it should come back to you. So you hold it like this and flick your wrist. So okay guys, I hope you enjoyed, and I really enjoyed this origami. This was really fun. If you want more origami videos, you can just put a like down below. If you want to see more origami videos, click here. Coming back to me. Let me show you one more time. This made completely out of paper.